Thank you, Artis. And Mike, and Farm Bureau, thank you for pulling together tonight's event. This is a great opportunity as a candidate. You want to get in front of voters and let them have an opportunity to hear directly from you and make a determination on who they feel like is best for this position. I want to recognize my wife, Shelly, who's here in the audience, and make sure she knows how much I love and appreciate her. Shelly and I are both from this area. We both went to Mississippi State. As you heard, I got undergraduate and graduate degrees there while playing baseball and basketball. We've been married for 20 years, and I have been living in Madison with our three kids since 2003. You heard a little bit about my background, conservative politics on national, state, and local levels. Economic development experience as Deputy Director of Mississippi Development Authority. I've had my own consulting business. In recent years, I was Chief Development Officer of Baptist Health Systems here in Jackson. And I resigned from that position 12 weeks ago to enter this race. So I make a joke when I meet with folks because I tell them, you know, I enjoy being married, I have three kids, and I'm out of a job. So I'm pretty serious about this. But I made it clear from day one that I'm gonna work hard in all 24 counties in this race. So you asked us to speak a little bit to why we're in this race, and so I'll just tell this audience, I'm driven by faith and family. I believe I'm answering a call to service. Shelly and I feel led in this direction, we feel prepared for this, and we believe I'm the best person for the job, and we believe I'll be successful for the same reasons I've been successful with everything else in life, and that is I'm willing to outwork people around me. I'm doing that right now. I've been campaigning since 12 weeks ago in all 24 counties, and we've been working hard. In fact, Shelly and I just 2 weeks ago campaigned in all 24 counties, and we did it in just 48 hours. So a lot of hard work, but a lot of fun too, and we're still happily married, I guess as of about 30 minutes ago. And so that's kind of reflective of where we are in this campaign. For the first 60 days, I traveled around helping people learn more about me and why I'm running. Now I'm talking a lot about what I'm for and what I'll do representing this district in Congress. I've released WITS game plan, kind of a snapshot of my policy priorities. And so, Artis, we clearly don't have time to touch on all those issues tonight. But I do want this audience to know that in Congress, I'm going to fight for more jobs and a stronger economy. Lower taxes, fewer regulations. Let's get the federal government out of the way so we have a chance to be successful. Look what's going on right now with the tax reform that was just passed. Lower taxes for businesses of all sizes. Touched 80% of Americans in a positive way. And so what have the results been? You've seen bonuses. You've seen increased wages, increased benefits, increased optimisms with business owners. We need to have more of that. I'm going to focus on immigration reform and border security. Border security is not a partisan issue. This is a national security issue. I believe that we need to build a wall where a wall makes sense logistically, and where it doesn't, we need to use technology. We need to have boots on the ground. We need to have boats in the water, more resources at checkpoints. But we're a nation of immigrants. We need a laws and rules driven process that will allow the best and the brightest to come here and contribute to society. We need an efficient and effective work visa program that will allow folks to come here for periods of time and work in our states like ours and be monitored along the way. So we got to be better on immigration and border security. I'm going to fight debt and spending. I'm very concerned about where we are from that standpoint. If you look at our debt right now, you're talking about $21 trillion in debt. 10 years ago when Obama got elected, we were at $10 trillion. If you look at our budget now, we're spending $4.4 trillion and we're bringing in $3.4 trillion. So we're adding another trillion to that number, and we're spending 300 something billion this year in interest and have nothing to show for those dollars. So anybody in a family or a small business knows we can't keep going in that direction. And it's interesting to note that over 50% of our debt is tied to entities associated with retirement for Americans. Whether you're talking about the Social Security Trust Fund or mutual funds or public and private pension funds. So if we risk defaulting on any level, we're not only gonna alienate ourselves with other countries around the world, we're gonna risk impacting current and future retirees in a negative way. And I just think that's unacceptable. I'm gonna support our military and our veterans. We have to give our military the resources they need to fulfill their missions and be successful. We have assets in the 3rd District that could be at risk in the next round of base realignment and closure. We need a person in Congress who understands the importance of that topic and understands how to get communities prepared for a potential next round of BRAC. We need somebody that understands the importance of paying attention to the priorities of our National Guard. The 3rd District footprint, from a Guard perspective, is the biggest footprint in the state. And it gets $600 million a year from the federal government. So we have to continue to sustain those resources. And I'm gonna campaign in, and I'm gonna work hard for all 24 counties, every community and every county in this district. The hard worker that you're seeing on the campaign trail right now is gonna be the same hard worker serving you in Congress. Now, I do wanna touch on some issues specific to that group with the rest of my time. And I'm gonna state the obvious.
About 4.5 minutes.
Okay. I'm gonna state the obvious and just say that clearly ag and natural resources are the backbone of the 3rd District. For that matter, the backbone of our state. And so we have to have a champion. That's not to suggest that the members of our congressional delegation right now don't make these issues a priority, but we have to have a champion. For a long time, we've always known Thad Cochran as that champion, and he's recently stepped down. So whoever represents this district has to be a champion for ag and natural resources. Now, I'm not gonna be up here and try to be clever and convince you that I'm an expert on issues like the waters of the U.S. or drift or traceability. I'm generally familiar with those issues, but I'll tell you, I know how to surround myself with good people. I know how to receive input from trusted voices like Farm Bureau. I know how to be my own person, be for what I'm for, and make smart, conservative decisions that I think are the right things for the right reasons. So let me just quickly roll through some issues here. First point I'll make is that government doesn't create a job, but I do think a member of Congress can help create the kind of environment that business owners appreciate. We have to do better in our tax and regulatory climate. We talked a little bit earlier about tax reform. In last night's debate, in terms of deregulation, we talked about Dodd-Frank. I think that's relevant for this audience. I mean, this is an area where they're trying to regulate the banking industry, but it ends up crippling Main Street. Our community banks are the lifeblood of our communities. And so 28,000 regulations later, instead of being able to hire more loan officers to give farmers and business owners access to capital, they're having to buy more accountants and compliance officers just to deal with the federal government. I think that's unacceptable. Transportation infrastructure. I can tell you from firsthand experience as an economic developer, I understand how important that is. You in this audience and others under the Farm Bureau umbrella, I understand you have to have good roads and bridges and rail and ports and airports. We have to do better, be more efficient, eliminate waste, fraud, and abuse, cut down the time it takes on permitting related to transportation projects, find those savings and reinvest them in those projects so you have the infrastructure you need to be successful, to bring materials in, to get finished goods and products out and serve your marketplace. Trade, I will tell you that I support the president and I want him to be successful because that means our country and our state have a chance to be successful. But I break from the president a little bit on this topic. I'm very concerned about what's going on right now with trade wars and tariffs. I do not think that's a good thing for jobs and commodity prices. I think you can look at what's going on right now with China as an example. I believe I'm correct in saying that China is our second biggest importer of our soybeans. If we price ourselves out of the market, so to speak, I'm quite certain there are growers and producers in South America that'll be glad to step into that gap. So we gotta have more trade opportunities, but they have to be free and fair. And it makes perfect sense to renegotiate NAFTA. I mean, it's 30 plus years old. I think it's perfectly reasonable to renegotiate NAFTA. Rural development. I'm not gonna get too detailed on this topic, but rural development is important in our communities. And one big thing we have to focus on is broadband. We have to have more high-speed fiber and broadband capacity and capability in our communities. Lastly, I will say, we have to have a congressman that understands the importance of sustaining research and development funding. That is so critical. I was reading some information about seed research. I'm not an expert on seed research. I know higher yields are a good thing in a competitive global economy. But we have to have these resources. And that doesn't have just direct impact, it has second and third tier impact in our communities. And I saw some numbers where 10 years ago, China and the US were spending $5 billion each on research and development. 10 years later, we're still spending $5 billion and China's spending $10 billion. That's not acceptable. So I'm running out of time, so let me finish with this. Somebody asked me the other day if I had taken a pole in this race. And I told them I don't have to. I am a pole. There's no better survey than talking to a candidate who's been everywhere in his or her district. And I can tell you that voters want somebody with character and integrity, somebody focused on jobs and economy, a strong leader with some backbone that values principles over politics, and somebody that will actually engage in the process and drive conservative legislation that aligns with priorities that people like you and I identify with.
All right.
I want to be that leader, and I'd like to have your support in this race. Thank you.
Thank you.